So they said that's why Yosef got the Bechorah. When Yosef got the Bechorah, he got the ability to daven and to poil. When Yosef got the ability to daven, he got the ability to daven for the right thing. He didn't just get the ability to daven from the fact that he was holy alone. His entire holiness he got from Yaakov Avinu. If you remember the Midrash, when the Midrash is saying, by the way, Likutei Moharan Torah Beis, I'm sorry. Anyhow, when we're talking about when Yosef was going through the Nisayon with the wife of Potiphar, what is the Midrash says? What's the thing that kept him, that enabled him to withstand the Nisayon?
His father's image. Yeah.
His father's image. He saw his father's image, which means he was mekabel the kedusha from Yaakov. It says, and the kedusha is the thing that enables you, to be zeichah be kedusha, you know, be the tefillah, right? So you see that the tefillah, which is a bechayra, which is pishnai, Yosef, got from Yaakov. I said yesterday that this constitutes the ability to look at the sechel amiti shebechol dovar. It is extremely difficult for a person to be machnia himself and to look at the sechel amiti of every single thing that happens. We have this aspect within us that when we don't get what we want, or that when we think we're not going to get what we want, we want to throw everything away. I remember I said this, as I said, you know, when I was young, you know, and I ate ice cream, the ice cream fell on the floor. I started crying. My mother told me, I buy another one. No, I want this one. But this one fell on the floor. I don't care. I want this one. You know, I don't want another one other than this one. Because that's the way I want it. I want that ice cream. And that I want that thing to be undone. That's what I want. Which means if I put my hand on it, you would have stayed. What?
What?
What was said? About the Adam HaRishon, when he sinned, he didn't die that day. Remember the question he had? And you had said that the decree was given that day, so he began dying.
So he died that day.
Uh-huh. Yeah. I said that?
Yes. We think that
it's on record.
That.
It's on record. Can
I do anything?
Maybe. So we said the inyan is to give the rotzen to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. You want something, daven for it. You want something to happen, you daven, it's going to happen. Look at the sechel amiti shebechol dovar. Why is Hashem doing it dafka this way, not that way? Because Hashem is teaching you something. Hashem is trying to tell you something. You know, bitul, anova, ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu to help you to get what you want dafka the way you want it. Is that Hashem? And if not, give it over to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. It's Mesiras Nefesh. I'm giving it up to you. Do with me whatever it is that you want. That's the meaning of Hestaklus al HaSechel HaAmiti. That's the meaning of Hestaklus al HaSechel HaAmiti. Giving yourself over to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Doing what is right. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu do what he wants. You want something else because it's a good thing for you. Ask for it. Ask for it. Daven for it. It'll happen. Zat Hashem. You know, but we have this yetzer just, you know, to, when we see that the game goes, you know, glimmering away, we want to kick the board and fly all the pieces. Yetzer. You be very careful. Mishpat. Or what's right, what's wrong. Listen, you cannot do anything about your feelings. You feel, what can you do? Nevertheless, what is right is right, what is wrong is wrong. You need to pass mishpat. And then ask for what is right. Ask for what you want.
Can one but go wrong if he like starts like complaining to Hashem, like?
No, Hashem is not a bear. Let's put things straight.
You just say, look, I don't want to sound brazen, but I don't like what you're doing to me right now.
So instead of saying, you can say, you know, that was I don't like the way it feels. I don't know what it feels. I don't understand why this is happening. It's okay, I don't have to understand. But nevertheless, you know, this is painful. This is difficult for me. You know what it is? Make it easy for me. But nevertheless, Rav Nosson says that you know, we said in the Halacha, hey, that tefillah la'oni kiyatov is when a poor person comes to Kodesh Baruch Hu and starts fighting with him, starts arguing with him. Kodesh Baruch Hu loves it. He says, how much more so if it's for Ruchnis? He says, that's even in Gashmias. He says, even in Ruchnis. Rabbeinu says, the Kodesh Baruch Hu loves it when you come up with good reasonings like, and you win over him. You win the trial. You know, you come with, Kodesh Baruch Hu gives his own, he gives his burden to win him over. You know, to defeat him, Kaviyachal. He gives his burden to defeat him, and whatever it is that... just go and look this way, that way, and say, well, you know, what's going to happen with me if I don't do this? If I don't, this is not going to happen. This is not going to, I'm not going to be in home, I'm not going to be this, I'm not going to be that. I'm going to eat with them, not eat with them, whatever. Oh, deal with it. He'll give you. Yeah. It's not just giving a call, ordering your ticket, and going. It's not a small thing. It's not a simple thing. All of a sudden, I'm sad. Ask until the end, until you're there. And then start asking. Not the same, everything should be right. Everything should be fine. Mishpat. Yes, Mishpat. This is about Dei Mazach Abchiras Mishpat. How can you attain the capacity to judge things properly? Al Dei Tzedaka. By doing Tzedaka. Al Dei Tzedaka, Uchazim Midas Mishpat. Through the Tzedaka, you're holding the Midas HaMishpat. This is a very, very pertinent nekuda. Moshe Kosov, Tzidkas Hashem, also Mishpatov. Hashem did the Tzidkas Hashem, also Mishpatov. It's Mishpatov, Tzedoka be'Yakov. Judgment and Tzedoka is in Yaakov. Ki Tzedoka v'de Mishpat. The Tzedoka is affected through the mechanism of Mishpat. Listen carefully. Moshe Kosov, Elohim Shofet, Hashem judges, says the Pasuk. Zei Yashpil, Zei Yarim. This one he puts down, and this one he brings up. So you see, when Elohim is Shofet, when Kodesh Baruch Hu judges, the act of judgment is putting down one side and lifting the other side. Because the judgment is like a seesaw, right? When somebody comes to a trial, you know, the judge says, you know, you're right and you're wrong. He lifts up this one and brings down this one, or the other way around. Right? That's the Inyan of Mishpat. So it said, Lechora, Mishpat, means, the Rebbe said before, that in Mishpat, the main thing is not to turn too much to the right and not to turn too much to the left. And here you're saying that Mishpat is lifting one side and lowering another side. So it's always either going to the right or going to the left, right? It's never really to the middle, right? You understand what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. The answer is, what is the judgment? This guy took from this guy. He put himself up and put the other guy down. The judge brings up this one and puts this one down, which in reality rectifies the situation from before. He's called Alayimsa. Right? Judgment is a rectification of a previous situation. So in
you can't judge something if nothing happened.
Right. The judgment is, you know, the act of judgment is the ability to lift something up and, you know, one side up and other side down, as a remedial step to a previous situation that happened before. That's Pchinas Mishpat. It looks lopsided, this one, and give it up like that. And he says, so Chazal said, Elokim shofet zeh yashpil v'zeh yarim. So what does it mean that he lifts up this one and he lowers this one? Shemoyrish lezeh u'mashir lezeh, that he impoverishes one and he enriches somebody else. That's what the Medrash says about this. You're doing the same thing when you're giving tzedakah. What are you doing? When you're taking your money, you're giving it to somebody else. You're making yourself poorer, and you're making the other one richer. In an act of doing kindness, of doing a mitzvah. So in this you are holding in the middle of Mishpat. You are lowering one, you're elevating the other in a good cause. With this, you are Pchinas Elokim Shofet. You are Zoichet to this Midas and Mishpat through the action, the physical action, Kiliyohol, of impoverishing one and enriching the other. Shemechaser Mamoino, this is Zeyashpil, you know, this one he impoverishes. Shemechaser Mamoino, you know, you're diminishing your own money. You're enriching the poor person. From this enables you to be oiches.
And then you can tomorrow.